I believe we are living right now in a very historic period, which I don't remember in my lifetime. We had a similar season like that. Over the last, you can say, almost 12 months, it started in May 2017, and it's culminating in May 2018. We had so many anniversaries. I never saw 12 months where we had so many anniversaries. The first anniversary started last year, was 50 years of the unification of Jerusalem. And if you just look at the city of Jerusalem, there is a jubilee cycle in place even until our days today, which for us, we discovered this only, or it came to our attention only the last 2 years when we started to think about it, that already in 1867, that is exactly 150 years ago, for the first time, a Christian archaeologist, his name was Charles Warren, came to Jerusalem. And he discovered what is known today as the City of David. He was the first man to dig down into the ground in Jerusalem and to archaeological research. It started not only the whole field of biblical archaeology, but what was more important, when he discovered in 1867 the foundations of the City of David, the Jewish people back in Russia, they said, now if the City of David is being found, it means we Jews have to go back to Israel. And this was leading to the very first wave of Jews making Aliyah to the land. Exactly 50 years later, on the year in 1917, General Allenby, another British Christian, came to the city of Jerusalem. He liberated Jerusalem from more than 400 years of Islamic oppression from the Muslim Turkish government. And it was like a breath of fresh air coming through Jerusalem, where the inhabitants were first of all free, but also it was laying the foundation what became later the State of Israel. Exactly 50 years after that, in 1967, Jerusalem was reunited. It was a divided city until that time, so it was reunited into one city. And this year, exactly 50 years after that means last year in December 2017, Donald Trump and the American administration publicly declared, we are moving the embassy to Jerusalem, recognizing Jerusalem as the capital. If you look at the 50 years period in the Bible, in Deuteronomy chapter 25, the Bible says it's a jubilee cycle where God is restoring the inheritance and the possession back to the owner. And I think this is what you saw so beautifully in taking place with the city of Jerusalem. It started with discovering the ancient heritage of Jerusalem, the city of David. Jews were coming back. It continued with the breaking of the Islamic yoke over the city and releasing the city from Islamic oppression. It went on uniting the city in one capital. And in this year now, we see the international recognition starting to come in, that the whole world recognizes it. And in the same way, you see another jubilee that you had, there's the 70th anniversary of the State of Israel, which we are celebrating this year. And in that context also, you can mention 120 years of Zionism. It was exactly 120 years ago when Theodor Herzl established the Zionist movement. In the Bible, the years 120 and 70, they are the limitation of a human age. In the book of Genesis chapter 6, God is telling Noah, my spirit shall not dwell with man longer than 120 years. And he was in a way giving the upper limit of a human age. And in the book of Psalm, in Psalm 91, Moses declares 70, when it is high 80, as the lower limit of a human age. So what I believe, what it means for the State of Israel, that they are completing now the life cycle of the Jewish people, or the life cycle of the Jewish state. And in a way, if you look, for example, to the Babylonian exile, 70 years of exile didn't mean, okay, now everything is at the end, but it actually started a new chapter for the Jewish people, where after 70 years of exile, God says, okay, now I'm moving into a new phase with the history of the Jewish people. And I do believe also that 70 years of Israel, 120 years of Zionism, that God is doing something new here in this land. God is opening a new chapter for the Jewish people. And what I personally believe, and that's my personal opinion, is like over the last 70 years or 120 years of Zionism, we saw the physical restoration of Israel. Israel returned back to their land. They became today one of the most successful nations in the world. The whole world is coming to Israel today for help in science and technology and computer science. But the biggest promises in the Bible, every prophecy, every prophet speaks about it, that is still outstanding, is, I believe, the spiritual restoration of the Jewish people. And I personally believe that we are entering into a new period, a new phase for the Jewish people, where God says, now I'm going to spiritually restore them. Like the prophet says, I'm going to pour out my spirit upon them. And I believe also it means a release of blessing for the church, because Paul says in Romans 11, he says, think about it, if they're falling away and their blinding already brought blessing to the Gentiles, how much more will their fullness be than life from the dead? And I do believe that once we see a revival here in this land, this will be ushering an incredible season of blessing also in the global church.